Ladies and gentlemen, the news which has come from Montevideo has been received with thankfulness in our island and with unconcealed satisfaction throughout the greater part of the world. The pocket battleship, Graf Spee, which has been for many weeks preying upon the trade of the South Atlantic, has met her doom. And throughout a vast expanse of water, the peaceful shipping of all nations may, for a spell at least, enjoy the freedom of the seas. The end of the raider came in the form most serviceable to those who have taken up arms in accordance with the covenant of the League and to all adherents of the cause of law and freedom in every land. The German pocket battleship, in spite of her far heavier metal and commanding range, was driven to take refuge in a neutral harbor by the three British cruisers whose names are on every lip. Once in harbor, she had the choice of submitting in the ordinary manner to internment, which would have been unfortunate for her, or of coming out to fight and going down in battle like the Royal Pindit, which would have been honorable to her. She discovered a third alternative. She came out not to fight, but to sink herself in the fairway of a neutral state from whom she had received such shelter and succor as international law prescribed. At that time, the pocket battleship, Von Spee, knew that the British heavy ships, Renown and Ark Royal, were still 1,000 miles away, oiling at Rio. All that awaited her outside the harbor were the 2 6-inch gun cruisers, the Ajax and the Achilles, who had chased her in, and the 8-inch gun cruiser, Cumberland, which had arrived to take the place of the damaged Exeter. Here, at home, in the North Sea, our British submarines have had the best week I can remember in this or the last war. A considerable proportion of the total German cruiser strength has been sunk or put out of action in a single week. And that, the same week in which, on almost the other side of the globe, the pocket battleship Graf Spee met her inglorious end. The Nazi Navy and Air Force are venting their wrath for these heavy blows by redoubling their efforts to sink the fishing smacks and drown the fishermen in the North Sea. And all yesterday and today, their Air Force has been trying to bomb individual unarmed merchant ships, including an Italian ship, which were moving up and down the east coast of Britain. They have even, in some cases, machine-gunned the sailors on the decks of these unarmed merchant ships and fishing boats. I'm glad to tell you, however, ladies and gentlemen, that the heat of their fury has far exceeded the accuracy of their aim. Out of 24 ships attacked by bombs yesterday and today, only 6 small boats engaged in fishing and 1 small coasting vessel have been sunk, and the bulk of the others have not even been hit by the many bombs cast upon them. Many vexatious tasks lie before the Royal Navy and before its comrades in the Merchant Navy, and as I always warn you, rough and violent times lie ahead. But everything that has happened since the beginning of this war should give the nation confidence that in the end, the difficulties will be surmounted, the problems solved, and duty done.